So I think, as we mentioned, it's all about finally ending in to make space for happiness. And that's what this whole make space of life is leading towards, how to make people happy. So that's.
Is the mic working? Yes. Nice video, Sonu, and must compliment you on the way you have presented the home. When I was looking at the video, मुझे वो पुराने एक गाने की याद आ गई कि एक महल हो सपनों का एंड ऑल दिस यू नो जितने हमारे बॉलीवुड के बहुत अच्छे लिरिक्स वाले गाने होते थे उसमें अगर आप ध्यान देंगे तो एक बहुत अच्छी बात बोली जाती थी कि मकान कोई भी बना सकता है घर इमोशन के साथ बनाए जाते हैं एंड व्हेन वी सी द वीडियो द इंट्रैक्शन जो आपने बोला जिस तरीके से आपने अपनी बात आगे रखी उससे पता चलता है इमोशन कितने स्ट्रॉन्ग है सर लेट मी फर्स्ट आस्क Anil sir, to thank Sonu for being part of this press conference and giving us this opportunity. But at the same time, I'll ask my media people if you have any question and answer to ask. You can proceed with your questions. Can we have a mic? Yeah, we can find the person first, sir.
Hello, hello. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
For Sonu, I'd like to ask you how do you maintain balance between your professional and personal life.
Hi sir, good afternoon. How are you doing? Always a pleasure to see you, sir. It's very important, especially when you are in this field and in this city, which always keeps you busy, always keeps you on your toes. So it's very important to have, I would say, a family that supports you to actually take care of you when you come back home, when you just want to unwind, and they are there to listen to you. They are there to guide you in your everyday routine. So I think it's important to stay connected with your roots. You know, when you tend to see the success that you always work hard for, you know, in all these years, there are chances that actually that your actual loved ones tend to disappear somewhere. So it's important to stay with the original people who were there always for you, to actually guide you, to correct you whenever you're wrong. And I think if you have right people around in the right ambience, so I think you can never go wrong. So that's the way I try to maintain my balance in the city. You know, all the friends I have, even today, are the friends who are in my college or school days, and you know, I love spending time with them.
Since you are a Bollywood actor, I'd like to ask you one more question about बॉलीवुड आपको लगता है कि बॉलीवुड को तीन चीज़ों से बहुत खतरा है ओटीटी हॉलीवुड एंड साउथ फिल्म से डू यू एग्री विथ मी
नहीं सर मैं थोड़ा एग्री नहीं करता हूँ क्योंकि मेरी जिंदगी की शुरुआत साउथ से शुरू हुई थी तो इसीलिए मैं इतने साल सर्वाइव कर पाया और अभी भी मैं साउथ की फिल्म कर रहा हूँ दो फिल्म अभी भी चालू है बट आई थिंक लैंग्वेज इज जस्ट आई वुड से एंटरटेनमेंट एक्चुअली डजंट हैव एनी लैंग्वेज आज अगर आप हिंदी चैनल्स देखें तो सबसे ज़्यादा साउथ की फिल्म्स डब फिल्म्स चलती हैं जो सबसे ज़्यादा लोग देखते हैं तो कहीं ना कहीं तो रीच उसका ज़रूर है बाकी उनके टेक्नीशियंस साउथ के सारे टेक्नीशियंस हिंदुस्तान में बॉलीवुड में काम करते हैं तो कहीं ना कहीं एक इंडस्ट्री बन चुकी है यू नो एक बहुत साल जब मैंने शुरुआत की थी 18-20 साल पहले साउथ से तब एक होता था कि एक तमिल है तेलुगू है कन्नड़ा अभी मैंने करीबन 16 से 17 भाषाओं में फिल्में की हैं सब लोग मिल के काम करते हैं The only, they have only one motive, which is to entertain people, which is good. And with OTT coming, I think it's again a huge leap if you talk about entertainment. You know, there were a lot of stories which were always untold because P&A ke budgets nahi hote the, release ke budgets nahi hote the. Ya phir wo producers aaj 52 hafte hamare paas hote hain ek saal ke andar. To bahut badi filmon ko to release mil jata tha, lekin choti films ya choti stories struggle karti thi. बट विद ओटीटी प्लेटफॉर्म्स आई थिंक वो फिल्म मेकर्स वो एक्टर्स वो कहानियाँ जो हैं वो उन लोगों तक पहुँची हैं कि आप अपने बेडरूम में बैठ कर उन्हें देख सकते हैं तो आई थिंक इट्स अ ग्रेट चेंज एंड विच इज डेफिनेटली गोइंग टू बूस्ट लॉ ऑफ करियर्स
Hi Sonu, first Hi. Of all a very nice good afternoon to you. I'm from Chandigarh, I'm a Punjabi, though I'm an army brat. But I would like to ask you that we all are living in metro, you're working in metro most of the time. I mean you do travel to for your work. How much it is different because I find people in Chandigarh, Moga, Amritsar very easy to understand relationships. like sir said, we are coming up to a stage where we are no more like human beings, because only 21% people are able to manage work-life balance, and most 79% is a dangerous figure. What would you suggest, and how would you relate it with your experience of making a good home for your sister?
You are, I would say, it's actually happening in every house with technology in every hand. People are living under one roof, but they are all living in their own worlds. If you enter a house, I would say 8 out of 10 houses you enter, so you'll see a father on a mobile phone with mother chatting with someone, and you know, kids are busy with their own PlayStations or games. So I miss those times when, as kids, we grew up talking to your parents and they had so many questions for you and you had so many questions to ask them. But nowadays, when everyone is so busy with technology, I think somewhere the relations are, I would say, getting shallow. So it's very important to actually, you know, stay connected and realize that, you know, how important emotions and those relations are. But still, I would say in smaller cities, people have time, you know, they pack up at 6, 7, they have, you know, at least a lot of hours to come back and spend time in a place like Bombay, when you spend 5 to 6 hours traveling, you know, up and down in the mornings and the evenings, and you're tired, and again you get back to your families and you just want to relax. You don't have time to talk to them, which is very scary. But I would say it's very important to find time for your family. You know, I remember there were times when I used to travel a lot for my outdoor schedules, but I used to make sure that my family used to travel with me. You know, no matter whole day I'm shooting, but I know when I pack up after my you know, schedule, I get to spend time with them, and while going for my morning schedules, I used to have breakfast with them. So I think at least that effort you have to put in to stay connected. Like you say about my sister, I speak to her every morning. I remember when my mother and father were there, the first thing I used to do in the morning was just to call them every single day. As soon as I'm leaving my house, the first call was to my mom or to my dad. And now, since they are not there, my first call is to my sister. I speak to them. I ask what happened, you know, last evening, or how did you spend your last day. So I think it's very important to know and to listen to them. In the world today we are living in, we have very few listeners. So I think it's very important to be a good listener in today's time. Yeah.
Thank you so much, Sonia. It's really indeed a very good example of yours, because you are much, much busier than all of us. Thank you so much, and we would really look forward to the good theme that Godrej Interio has brought up today. It's really, in fact, enlightening. Thank you.
Thank you.
Sir, one question. Children of the 90s will realize this. Mummy, Papa, Amisha, bolte the ki dining table pe kuch baat mat karo. Sif khane pe dhyan do aur ek dusre se baat karo. You have a busy schedule, and I also looked at the AV, so we realize you like to cook also. Whenever you go back to your home with your sister, do you cook and have that alone time on that dining table? Do you eat together?
Of course we do. You know, nowadays when most of the people are glued to televisions and they want to eat food, watching a movie or some whatever favorite program. So I think dining tables are, I would say it's, dining table is the only instrument, I would say, in the house that can put the family together. So you have to make those rules together, like no matter what important program is coming or what important cricket match is coming on, just leave it aside and spend those 20-25 minutes on a dining table where you can, you know, spend time with the family, and you will actually feel, I would say, rejuvenated when you actually listen to them or talk to them. I think that should be the rule of every single house. These few rules we follow in Punjab and in Mumbai, and I hope this has to be followed in every home.
Yeah, absolutely.
Question?
Hi.
That's
hello. Yeah. Hi, Sonu and Anil sir. First of all, thank you very much for a very nice and emotional presentation. Okay, my question is like making space for life. How it is different from creating optical illusion?
Creating?
Optical illusion.
Optical illusion.
Yeah. Yeah. Normally, that how when we go to see a sample flat, there things look different. But when I actually take possession, then it becomes very difficult to fit the same thing, because in market you don't find the same size of bed and almirah and wardrobe.
No, I think See, Make Space for Life is a higher platform where the it's important to understand who's going to be there and what they want to, what their personality reflects and how they want to live their life. You know, so these are three important elements that is very important. Post that, we can create through interior designing, through a 3D modeling, interiors of the home to give the feeling of people. You know, once you are able to understand what their likes and dislikes are, like someone would like light colors, someone would like more pastels. So how do you actually bring out the personality of the person in the house and convert that into home with this personality? That creates something like Make Space for Life. Then he starts feeling that this is my home, this is my life. And that is where the change occurs in the individual. But if you, as you rightly said, if you just put some bed, some table, some chair, it's some total will not give you a thing. It has to be, the total has to be decided first, and then you look at the various components that go into it. That's how the Make Space for Life comes through. And at our stores, we help customers trying to understand what they are in for, what are their likings. Like today, you may like a very straight line bed. Someone may like a very opulent looking, a curved thing. So what do you like? So what do you prefer? And from that, how do you deduce your personality and then create the thing? So that when there is an atmosphere, when there is an environment, automatically we tend to be associated with that environment. If the environment is not conducive, then the association becomes a little away. Like Sonu talked about saying that your kitchen is so beautiful that I don't mind going there and cooking. You just imagine if the kitchen was not good, maybe his passion of cooking, which he wanted to do, would not have occurred. Yes,
please. Pass the mic there.
Yeah, hi. So when you take up a contract or an assignment, what is the minimum area that you are looking for, or is there a budget that you are saying that this, at least this much is the thing? So how does it work? And what is the approximate square feet, cost per square foot?
I think we don't come from that at all as to what is the cost per square foot. We come from what, like we have done one bedroom apartments also. We have done maybe five bedroom houses also. So it is not coming from just saying that this is the square foot area. As I said, it's not about the cost. It's about bringing in the right elements. So it may be that you could be able to do a very good interiors job to create a personality at a much lower rate, at a lower cost, than just trying to put in everything that is expensive into that place and making it a five-star hotel which doesn't look like your home.
Thank you. So, jaise humne kaha ki home mein emotions ki bahut zarurat hai, I think that's where sir is also hinting at that. In the end, it's about your personality, it's about your lifestyle, and that decides how you want to make your home look like. On that point, I would like to play another video which shows the emotional side of Sonu. From his perspective, how does that home look? On that note, I'll request Sonu and Anil sir to please stand up for photo opportunity for our people to click the images.
So let me first thank Sonu for giving us this opportunity to work with him, because he was such a passionate person, someone who believed in what we stood for. And it was a pleasure to work with a person who believes in what we stood for.
Well, first of all, sir, I would like to thank you for making this happen. Main wahi bolta hu ki aap sab busy ho jayenge apne professions mein, jitne press aaya hu wo yahan se dusri ek conference mein jayenge, interior ki team ek ghar se dusre ghar mein jayenge, main bhi ek film se dusri film mein chale jaunga, lekin सबसे इम्पॉर्टेंट चीज़ ये है कि जो इंटीरियर की टीम ने साथ में मिलके जो रूप दिया उस घर को, वो हर दिन, हर घड़ी, हर पल मेरे लिए बहुत इम्पॉर्टेंट, बड़ा स्पेशल रहेगा. एंड एवरी सिंगल डे आई वुड लाइक टू टेल यू दैट हम, हमारे घर के अंदर चार पांच लोग नहीं हैं अभी, गोदरेज इंटीरियर की टीम भी हमारे साथ ताजिंदगी रहने वाली है.
थैंक यू वेरी मच. थैंक यू. थैंक यू सो मच.
थैंक यू सर.
Push
कर.
एक सोलो 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 लुक या प्लीज सर ये मैम थोड़ा पीछे हुआ रुक क्या सर ये प्लीज अगेन सुनो पाजी क्या सबको बहुत काम कर थैंक यू सर
Okay, so you know, we have seen already seen a beautiful house you have just in a video, but tell us something about your association with Godrej Interior.
Hi. you know, the my association started with Godrej years back when I made my first house for my dad almost 6 to 7 years ago, and I would say it was so special that I still have those fond memories, and my dad was very excited to see the new place. Everything was changed in week 10 days, everything changed. Every single corner of the house looked fantabulous. And now after so many years, when I wanted to do something for my sister, and I would say I couldn't think any other name other than Godrej Interior, and the way they transformed the whole place, it looks straight out of some magic books.
But what was that one thing, you know, you specifically wanted when you created this house for your sister?
No, one thing I really wanted was, I wanted it very timeless, I would say. Even after 10 years, it should look classy.
Right.
Minimalistic grays, lot of classy blacks, grays, and on those lines only. Not too many colors, but something which people should say that, you know, a lot of time and a lot of energy has been put into actually create these spaces. So I think that was the challenge which I would say Godrej people really made this happen. Yeah.
You know, talking about the Bollywood celebrities, a lot of people have a beautiful house. Any preference taken from anyone's house, like किसी का घर पसंद आया हो?
बड़े सभी लोगों के घर बड़े अच्छे, but actually reference कहीं से नहीं था. मेरा एक मैं खुद बड़ा मुझे बड़ा शौक है, you know, घर बनाने का, और मैंने एक चीज़ ज़रूर सोची थी कि घर ऐसा बनाना है जो जहाँ पर ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा समय बताने की इच्छा हो. यू नो, अक्सर ऐसा होता है कि आप बहुत सारा खर्चा करते हैं, बहुत सारा फर्नीचर रख देते हैं, भर देते हैं घर को, तो वो एक डेफिनेटली एक स्ट्रिक्ट इंस्ट्रक्शन था कि कम से कम चीज़ें रखी जाएँ और स्पेशियस दिखना चाहिए घर. तो आई थिंक दैट वॉज ओनली actually point that was you know asked Godrej to maintain it, and the interior people did.
But as you said, you know, bahut sare logon ke ghar acche hain. Any specific person jiska ghar aapko acha lagta ho from Bollywood?
I would say Shah Rukh's house is pretty very pretty, you know, very nicely done. Bahut samay bitaya hai, and I think Gauri being an
interior
person,
designer,
she travels a lot, she has done those fine detailing that required for a house, and I think everyone's house is very beautiful. Yeah. Yeah.
So as we are talking about making a space for a life, tell me one person for whom you want to make a space in your life, but you know, because of work, you that doesn't becomes possible for you to make a space.
No, I do put an effort to make a space for everyone whom I want in my life, and I think you always need to put an extra effort to make that happen. There are no excuses when you talk about your the people whom you love. You have to put those extra efforts to make that happen. Yeah, my family, obviously, my sisters, my family, everyone. I try to spend as much as time I can with them, and I make sure that, you know, in my life, the space for them always remain that, you know, intact, and whenever they are free, they have to fill that space. Yeah.
Okay, one more thing I would like to know is that, you know, knowingly or unknowingly, anyone from Bollywood who have helped you somewhere or the other?
I think every single actor, every single director, every single cinematographer, every single producer that I worked in all these years have really made a difference. You know, from my very first film, Bhagat Singh, to the last, Simba, if I talk about, every single technician from a spot boy on the sets made that film look the way it is looking now. So I think without those people, it was not possible for me to reach where I am today. And of course, you know, all you people who are the real connection with every single individual living in different parts of the world. So I think media also has been a huge support for me to achieve whatever little I've achieved in my life.
We have seen you sharing your happiness for working with, you know, YRF. But tell me about the status about the film. How is it going? What's the status for the film?
Yeah, it's, the shoot is going on. It's one of the most expensive films coming up this year, Diwali. And Akshay and me, we have worked almost in 3 to 4 films together.
Right.
Here, and all the films were huge hits. So we hope to create that magic again, and I'm sure, you know, Prithviraj coming up and Dr. Chandraprakash Dwivedi and Aditya Chopra, you know, who are the masters in the craft, will make sure that this is going to be the biggest film
and
of this year.
And how is it working with multi-star film, you know, multi-cast?
It's always, you know, on the sets and off the sets, it's always a great feeling, you know, spending a lot of time together and, you know, sharing your experiences. And, you know, I think when on off the sets you enjoy, the film looks magical.
Right. Okay, besides this, anything new which we are not aware with or you would like to share with us?
My home production, PV Sindhu, it's almost on the pre-production stages, so hopefully some good announcements coming very soon. I'm starting my 2 South movies also this year. And yeah, with Prithviraj and 2 South movies and my home productions, the hands are full. But like I said, you know, this year is important, so yeah, I have to give my best. Yeah.
Wishing you all the very, very luck. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.